Good morning, students, and welcome to another online life science classroom of St. Michael's Academy. Today I am going to discuss silkworm, as I have completed already honeybee in your class. So that today I am starting with silkworm. So let's start the class. So we are starting with silkworm. Bombyx mori, which is the scientific name of silkworm. Bombyx is the genus and mori is the species. You can see Bombyx mori or silkworm. This is the silkworm, follow the leisure. The domestic silk moth. So Bombyx mori, the domestic silk moth, is an insect from the moth family Bombycidae. So moth family of moth is Bombycidae. It is the closest relative of Bombyx mandarina, which is the wild silk moth. So Bombyx mandarina is the scientific name of silk moth, or rather you can say a wild silk moth. But remember that Bombyx mori is the scientific name of the domestic silk moth. The silk worm is the larva or caterpillar of a silk moth. This is the definition of a silk worm. This is a larval stage, or rather you can say a caterpillar stage of a silk moth. It is an economically important insect, being a primary producer of silk. Life cycle of silk worm. Silk is a natural fiber which comes from the cocoons of silk worms. First, you see the diagram. Just follow the diagram with the statement. This is the cocoon form. First egg, then larval stage, and the next one is cocoon. This is actually silk worm. Just now I have said the caterpillar stage, and this is the adult silk moth. You can see. So silk is a natural fiber which comes from the cocoons of silkworm. So we can get silk from this stage, that is cocoon. Which are the larvae of the mulberry silk moth Bombyx mori? A female moth lays 300 to 500 tiny eggs, and after around 10 days the larvae or silkworms hatch. So this is the egg actually. So this type of egg, around 300 to 500 a female moth can lay at a time, and around 10 days, that means after laying the eggs, after 10 days the larvae form. A pupa is the life stage of some insects undergoing transformation. The pupal stage is found only in holometabolous insects, those that undergo a complete metamorphosis. You know which is metamorphosis? The biggest example and easiest example of metamorphosis is in toad life cycle, from tadpole to a mature toad. Already you know that, I have said you. So here also metamorphosis means the change of stages in lifestyle. So going through four life stages. First one is embryo. Just follow the leisure. Egg or embryo. Second one is larval stage. That is this one, or silkworm. Third one is pupa. Pupa or cocoon. And the fourth one is imago. That is adult moth. So during the pupal stage, only in the case of Bombyx mori, they produce silk. So it is the exception of a silkworm. Hope so you have understood. You have understood the diagram also, because you have to draw this diagram. Now the question is, how silk is produced from silkworm? And see, this is a silkworm and this is silk. So silk production. The process of silk production is known as sericulture. You know what is apiculture? Just before the silkworm, and this is sericulture. Extracting raw silk starts by cultivating the silkworms on mulberry leaves. Once the worms start pupating in their cocoons, that means they are forming pupa within the cocoon. These are dissolved in boiling water in order for individual long fibers to be extracted and fed into the spinning rill. Hope so everyone knows about silk. Silk is a very familiar word to all of us in case of cloth, especially shirt, silk shirt, silk sari, everything. So very well known thing. So this is the way how silk is produced from the pupal stage of a silk moth. Now what are the uses of this silk? Raw silk is used for clothing such as shirts, suits, ties, blouses, lingerie, pajamas, jackets. Hand spun mulberry silk used for making comforters and sleeping bags. Other variety fabric materials like dupions, plain silk, deluxe, satin, chiffon, chinos, crepe, brocades are made from mulberry silk. So these are the uses of silk. You can write this by point wise. So hope so you have understood. This is a very easy thing. If you have not understood, so please ask me in my coming live class. Till then, bye bye and have a nice day.